Asset to be collected. Asset requiring collection. Assets in the air. Asset delivery confirmed.
Ancient mythology may not be my speciality, but I've been told that Moros Intrepidus was named after the Greek deity Moros, the personification of impending doom. It was said that he gave people the ability to foresee their demise. And if you come face to face with this Tyrannosaur, I suspect there is a good chance you will meet your fate.
Transit has commenced. Asset delivered. Transporting asset. Asset delivery. Commencing asset transit. Transportation complete.
You might think that the Sinoceropteryx is the perfect size for a cute plushie to take home. But this dinosaur is a pretty mean hunter for something so small. Trust me, you really don't want this one snapping at your heels. People often talk about the thrill of the chase, but if you got one of these on your tail, you'll soon become the kill of the chase. This right here is the Atrociraptor, a truly tenacious hunter, and it is simply relentless. At least, that's what I'm told. I don't intend to find out firsthand.
I'm a fairly trusting individual. But if you were to tell me that you'd seen anything like this before, I'm not sure I'd believe you. This Tuscotherapsid is Lystrosaurus. Astonishingly, this species managed to survive the Permian-Triassic extinction and went on to thrive as the dinosaurs began to populate the Earth. Here's hoping it can enjoy a long tenure this time around, too.
Has been delivered.
The Eutyranus. The feathered tyrant brought so much excitement, so much intrigue to the scientific community when it was first discovered. And here we find ourselves in the presence of that illustrious tyrannosaur. Just don't be too surprised if it ruffles a few feathers, okay?
Back from extinction if you can find a way to make that fun and exciting and profitable, huh? That's where Isaac Clement comes in. He deals with the show, I deal with the business, huh?
You ask me, I think this animal gets a bad rap. Back when fossils were all scientists had to go on, this Mongolian dune dweller was branded an egg thief. But you know what? It was really just looking out for its own. So as far as I'm concerned, the Oviraptor is all right in my books.
Asset in transit.
Here we have the Dinochirus. This downy dinosaur is often likened to an ostrich. Not surprising, I suppose, considering the long neck, the feathers, the beak. It's just a lot bigger in size, huh? But if things go awry, something tells me this swan doesn't need to bury its head in the sand.
Transportation underway. Transported. Asset transported. Has been transported.
This fuzzy little reptile is the Jaelopterus. It's pretty cute, huh? Well, you see those tiny little fangs? They'll give you a nasty nip if you're not careful. So be careful. Well, if nothing else works out for you, at least we know you're pretty good with a camera. This entire operation started with a dream that was realized through science. For that, we can thank Dr. Henry Wu.
Whenever a dinosaur dies, I feel like I've lost one of my own.
Minmai is a relatively small, armored herbivore. From Cretaceous Australia. What sets this species apart from other members of its family are the horizontally orientated plates that run along the sides of its backbone. Hence the binomial name, Minmai paravertebra.
Thank you. Hey, Owen Grady here. I'll keep it brief, and that's it. Done. I'm working with the raptors. They know I'm one of them. No stress. That's what we want with the animals.
This may seem inhumane, but when we let the dinosaurs fight, or when we manipulate them too, we gain a greater understanding of the animals. This research may eventually help us to better manage them.
Thank you.
I've gone, like, hours without a snack. I know how that makes me feel. So imagine how a dinosaur feels when it's hungry.
George Lambert, in charge of security. And I just want to remind you of the safety of our guests and our dinosaurs. Well, that's job one. Not much gives me the chills, but this is something else. Now listen to me very carefully. It is imperative that you keep the Scorpius Rex under control. If this thing escapes, I'm not even gonna go there.
What can I say? The Indominus Rex remains my most inspired creation. Nature can create a dinosaur, but only I can bring an Indominus Rex to life. To do so required a tremendous amount of research, gene mixing, splicing and manipulation, and, of course, determination. The end result? Is a hybrid dinosaur that is both beautiful and deadly. An alpha predator among alpha predators. So treat it with the care and respect it deserves. This is a dinosaur created with a purpose. It can even see in the dark and uses echolocation to find its prey. Now, nature might eventually have created the Indoraptor, but I got there first. Is it dangerous? Yes. But then so is science.